Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87, and once again, to those of you who keep the Sabbath, happy Sabbath. Now, I'm going to break down a scripture to help clarify a misrepresented understanding that some people out there have, and that scripture is John 3:16. There are plenty of people out there who believe that all you have to do is believe according to John 3:16. Now, for the Father's word to hold true, which I believe 100%, you do have to believe. Yes, you have to believe, but I know there's much more to it than that. I don't just hang on to the notion that all you have to do is believe, and you shouldn't either. So, with that being said, let's break down John 3:16 with just believe. Okay, let me say this from the onset. It would be a wonderful thing if all we had to do is believe in the Heavenly Father and His Word and be assured a place in heaven. That would mean that we could all go on and live our life and do anything that we wanted and believe in Him. Let me tell you, there are plenty out here who believe in Him 110%. That are not going to make it to heaven because they're out here doing things that are guaranteeing that they won't. We have to do more than just believe. There is a work involved. Believing is only part of it. Now, let's read John 3:16 and start right there. It reads, it says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Now listen to what the scripture is saying. It says that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish. It did not say that they won't perish or that they couldn't perish. It says that they should not perish. And that makes total sense. If you believe in Him, you should not perish. Because if you believe in Him, you should be doing all the other things that He requires of us. You should be following every law that He has given us. You should be doing all the things that a righteous person is doing, but that's not the case. That is why this scripture goes right on and says, should not perish. So those who believe have a work ahead of them. Now, let's go to James 2:19 and read that, because the devil also believes, and I don't think any of us have the notion or idea in our head that he is going to make it. But I'm going to show you. James 2:19 says that even he believes. James 2:19 reads, it says, "Thou believest that there is one God. Thou doest well. The devils also believe and tremble." And then verse 20 says, "Wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead?" So in just three verses, John 3:16, James 2:19, and 20, we're told that we have to believe, and then we're also told to eliminate that notion that that's the only thing we have to do, that the devil also believes, and then in James 2:20, we're told that faith without works is dead. Okay, now that can be the end of this study right here, because that would do it for me. We have more to do than just believe and then go on living our life any way we want. We're given an example with the devil. He believes, and we know some of the stuff that he does, and he's not going to make it. So there is a work ahead of us. So next, let's move on a little bit longer to eliminate one notion and solidify another notion that we have a work to do. Okay, let's go back to John 3, and we're going to start with 17. Read that one in 18. 17 reads, "For God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved." Pay attention. It said, "might be saved." It didn't say the world through Him will be saved. It said, "might be saved," because some of us, even through Him, are not going to make it, because we're not going to go through Him. We're going to go our own way and not take advantage or that opportunity to go through Him and be saved. So only some are going to do that. Verse 18, he that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Listen to what it's saying. It says, he that believeth on him is not condemned. Okay, so those who believe in him are not condemned at that point already because they believe in him. But you can be condemned by going on and doing all these other things. Because you believe in him, you're not condemned there. There are others who are already condemned because they don't even believe in him. Satan is not condemned at that point because he believes in him. Satan is condemned because of what? His iniquity. And there are going to be plenty of others that go that route. They're going to be condemned because of their sin, not because they don't believe in him. So keep this in mind. People who believe in him have a path that they can follow to be saved. That doesn't guarantee that they're going to be saved because they believe in him. There's a work to do. You can't only just believe. You have to hear his word. You have to live his word. You have to live his laws. There is a lot to do. We cannot just believe and go our own way. Okay, let's go to one final scripture before I close this out. John 8:51 reads, it says, verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death. Okay, what is this saying? His laws, his will, all these things, whatever he says that we're to do, those are the things that we're to do. We are to keep his saying. We are to do the things that he has asked of us, those things that are required of us to do. We are to do these things. If we do this, we will be saved. We have to believe first. See, believing is only the first step. Then there's a work to do. Can't get past anything if you don't believe. And once we believe in him, we can move forward. But like I said, I'm going to keep it short and simple and to the point. So remember, with that being said, that the Heavenly Father does not call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. Listen to his word and do what's required. Do more than just believe. This is 2Bay7. I'm out.